Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Last time I took the rear end out of my car to get the broken spring sorted, and the eagle-eyed amongst you may have noticed that my spring pack was assembled wrong, in that in the top there were too many leaves and in the bottom there were too few, and that makes for an imbalance in how the springs work. You see, originally the way it should look is a regular stacking where the length difference between each leaf is the same. And on mine, you had long, long, then a huge gap, and then short, 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 all stacked up on top of each other. And that made for essentially one spring leaf doing all the work, which may result in a spring leaf breaking. So the only logical consequence is to take the damn thing apart again and get it sorted. Due to a couple of lucky coincidences, I was able to sort out the missing spring leaves from the same guy that gave me the first one, and huge thanks to him, of course. The only issue we had is that he didn't have the proper leaf that went into the sequence that I needed, but only the lowermost leaf. And so I had to do a little bit of adaptation, meaning it had to be shortened, then it had to be re-arched a little bit. And then I had to drill the holes for the spring shackles to go in between them. No big deal, really. People reverse their springs completely, so I don't think it's going to be any problem to have the contact surfaces bent a little bit. And well, I did a couple of things differently this time. We're going to see if it goes any faster, and we're going to do a couple of more slight little modifications to the car while we're at it. Enjoy! So before we jump into the rear end removal again, let me just quickly elaborate on something else that has been going on simultaneously. That was the shock links, because they were badly worn on mine. Some of these brass bushings were actually worn so thin that you could see through them. And, you know, I decided to just machine new brass parts and put them in there, reassemble everything. But it didn't take 200 miles and they just fell apart. What happens is these tiny brass pieces just get dislodged and locate themselves somewhere in the shock link, just not where they're supposed to sit. And, you know, taking them apart, putting them back together is quite a lengthy job. It's covered in grease and dirt and it just isn't any fun. So what I decided to do this time is substitute the original style shock links with the later V8 style, which are just much simpler. They have rubber bushings instead of this stacking of springs and spacers and brass bushings and screws to adjust the tension inside. It's just much simpler, and if it lasts longer than the original style shock links, which I'm pretty sure they will, then it's just a no-brainer to switch over to them. They look more elegant too, in my opinion. Now for the rear end removal. Nothing too different from last time. I'll put captions underneath it so you know what I'm doing. And cue the music. Thank you.
du.
Okay, ja, dann. Und dann? Das hört sich doch gut an, oder? Ja, jetzt ist es
doch. Hat auch einen Ruck nach oben getan.
Ja. Well, that's the rear end part done. Man, I'm getting good at this. 6 hours for this job. We wanted to actually tackle the rear drum situation where there was a shim in between. At the time that we first discovered it, I didn't have a shim, but now the second time round, I got my hands on one. And the plan was to take the drum off, clean off the taper seat and replace the shim, obviously. However, we didn't get the drum off there. So rather than busting the hub puller, I decided to just leave it be, check it regularly for play, and you know, tackle with the issue once the drum is loose again, if ever. Last not least, to have something to distinguish this video from the last one, I decided to lend a friend's GoPro and mount it underneath the frame to see how the spring is actually acting. Here is the recording, and with that, I thank you once again very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye!